there's a lot happening with Stephon Gilmore. Defensive MVP, which is a couple years ago, candidate, I think. Last year played 11 games, did not opt out, played for the Patriots defense, in which a lot of guys opted out. Suffered a partially torn quad, I believe. Mm-hmm. Played 11 games. Now he's going into the last year of his contract with $7.3 million due and owed to him. He is officially a no-show at the mandatory minicamp in New England. Belichick was asked about it this morning. He said there's some weather issues with some people's travel. We're not 100% sure who's here and who isn't here. Is that Stephon Gilmore, or is Stephon Gilmore actually not there? Jalen Ramsey from the LA Rams has gone on to Instagram and said, hey, what's good? Why don't you come on over to LA, pal? There's been plenty of people in the past who have gone from Boston to LA in one. People are recruiting Stephon Gilmore. I don't know if players are the ones deciding where Stephon Gilmore's going. I assume the people that are deciding are those who have to renegotiate an extension contract with Stephon Gilmore, but that's a guy I would love to get into our building immediately if I had a little bit of a defensive inefficiency somewhere. Ooh. He takes you over the hump maybe, but he's holding out. It's bad news in New England, AJ.
Hey, but do they are they upset that he's holding out? Like, they, it's been known that they've been trying to trade him, right?
Yeah, for like 2 years, it sounds like. Yeah. And I think it's all because his age, potentially, and the future contract, the Patriots aren't going to pay him the next contract. I think Stephon knows that. I assume Bill and the Patriots have been acting as such. So this has been something that's been talked about for a few years. Thought maybe before the draft something was going to happen. Now nothing. Now he hasn't shown up. As a Patriots fan, your thought? You guys are bringing in a lot of good players. Why is it time now to get rid of a great player? That's something I'm thinking.
Kind of a bummer. Rob Ninkovich talked about it before on the show about how, like, it's not really what you've done before. It's what are you going to do. The torn quad doesn't help. And also, J.C. Jackson, the younger rookie corner who had the 9 picks last year, he got a first-round tender. They're probably gearing up to pay him next year.
Yeah, but they paid everybody, and salary cap means nothing. Is there something wrong behind the scenes?
Whoa.
We will find out.
That's what they do, though. You know, the Patriots aren't scared to move on from guys that made a ton of plays, but they may be considered a bit old, which I don't even think Gilmore is. He's coming off the quad, though.
He's 30.
Yeah.
He's 30 years old.
Playing. As a corner? Yeah, it's not young.
Yeah, but he's also just an absolute stud.
I'll sign him right now. If I'm a GM, I'll sign him.
I'd sign him right now as well, but you're right. I mean, Teddy Bruschi was basically allegedly like, hey, we're going to cut you, you're retiring.
Yeah.
Seymour, Braves, they all got traded.
Yeah, Vinatieri, too. I think there was even conversation about how he's 11 years in or 10 years in. He would go on to have another 12 years somewhere else. But I think that is something Tom, obviously. Bill Belichick says, hey, I'm going to be early out instead of late in. And that's, I guess it's worked for a long time. But how often can you ship greats out of the building and still win? We'll find out. They've been doing it for 20 years. We got an update on Stephon Gilmore news. AJ Hawk, Stephon Gilmore, a situation unfolding in New England. Cornerback Stephon Gilmore, who skipped mandatory practice today, is planning to skip the rest of minicamp as he seeks a new deal per Andrew Callahan. New England could opt to fine him $93,000 for his absences. I think that is the max amount of money you can be fined for missing mandatory minicamp. That was the same exact amount that Aaron would have been fined. Gilmore is in the final year of his deal with a $7 million base salary. The contract, the future contract, the new deal has been something that has had Stephon Gilmore on the trade block for a couple years now. Now it is official per Andrew Callahan via At My Sports Update. Stephon Gilmore says, I ain't doing none of it. If you ain't giving me a long-term deal, get me the fuck out of town. Interesting, fascinating. This is a great football player, AJ Hawk, and there are teams that need a corner.
Yes.
There are teams that also are potentially interested in Richard Sherman, who's available right now. How's that affect everything? I don't know. AJ, your thoughts?
Well, would he have been able to participate if he showed up? Is his quad healed enough?
He's still rehabbing it.
So he wouldn't even had to do that. So he would have had to probably rehab, stand on the side, a lot of conversations, I assume.
Either way, though, is there any chance he's back in New England this year?
Hey, last year it was a chance he wasn't coming back. Mm-hmm. And then he, instead of opting out, he opted in and then played good football. And I don't know. Where's he going? He's gone. Now, you guys are already, like, Patriots fans have already come to grips with him being gone.
I feel like because of the trade rumors for a while now, it's just been like, okay, Gilmore's probably not someone who's going to be here after this contract. But it is the final year, and it says new deal. But if they give him, say, $5-6 more million dollars, you think he'd play one more season then hit the road?
Hey, do it one more. Hey, you and me, we've been around. Mm-hmm. Okay, one more. Let's do this thing right, okay? play out this contract. We'll give you an extra $5 million, $12 million bucks. Mm-hmm. Huh? Not too shabby. And then we'll kick you the fuck out of the building.
Go get that new deal.
Now, you might get hurt, okay? You might get hurt. So this might be the last money you make for the rest of your life. But how about it, huh?
That's football, baby.
How about we do that whole thing?